here, Dr. Lepora here, excited to continue our conversation on diversity, equity, and inclusion. And this one is about what does equity have to do with it anyways? And the reason why I decided to create this message is because there are many leaders reaching out asking me, what is equity? And so I applaud them for asking the question. And the reason that is because a lot of people are throwing out buzzwords, diversity, equity, and inclusion. This is a great thing because of all these atrocious things that have been receiving higher levels of exposure in the news within the past year and more. And to me, it's very important to understand the difference of these concepts. Why is it important? Because it requires different tools, different steps in order to reach them as goals. And first and foremost, it requires an appreciation of these three elements individually, respectively, because they are different elements in order to make a difference. Awareness is that first phase, as we know, in any healthy transformation. And appreciation is that second phase. So if people are not aware regarding what it is, they cannot appreciate it. And if they can't appreciate it, well, they really can't do anything about it in an intentional way. So let's just talk about the different definitions of all three and not just equity to provide clarity. So diversity is pretty much a diverse number being the operative word of people, of elements within your organization, within your environment. So diversity is purely talking about numbers. So whether you have, for example, 10% African American or 20% Indian or 5% Native American or whatever diverse category you want to use, we're talking about numbers when we're talking about diversity. So when you're talking about increasing diversity within your organization, you're talking about increasing the variety numerically of these respective represented groups. And sometimes within diversity, of course, organizations want to specifically target certain groups in order to expand that number within the organization. Why do they do that? For various reasons. For one, because it may more so reflect their customer base. It may be the area of representation that is specifically lacking within their organization. However, essentially and fundamentally, diversity means those numbers that are represented within your organization of these variety of categories that are represented from the majority as well as those of the minority. Now let's get into inclusion, because inclusion is probably a more commonly understood definition as well, similar to diversity. Now inclusion is talking about being inclusive within your organization. So when we hear inclusion now, what we are assuming is that inclusion is talking about being inclusive of everyone. And what does that mean? When you have an inclusive environment, it is a welcoming environment. It is not only a welcoming inside the door of your organization, it's a welcoming environment inside of the respective areas of your organization. So that means input into financial decision making. That means at the lunch tables, for example, it's a welcoming environment. That is when there are project teams being developed that have a large impact on a rollout of your organization. It is inclusive of all the different people within your organization. It is inclusive of ideas. So for example, if there's a discussion of decisions that are going to be made and there's a staff meeting, an inclusive environment would be inclusive of the ideas that are within that room. It would be inviting of what these different ideas may represent. So an inclusive environment is one that is warm. It's one that is connected. So it's one that is opposite of what you would think of when you would think of a very cliquish environment, you know, where everyone has their little segments, little corners, and you really cannot penetrate those barriers, those barricades within each clique. An inclusive environment is one that is more collaborative, where people are welcome and warm toward each other. It's a very specific culture, and you know it when you see it. And it's not one that typically happens without intention, because it is one that is intentionally going to make an effort to be inclusive of all of those people who are different. And it makes it counterintuitive to our instinct oftentimes to categorize ourselves. So So that is the essence of what inclusion is and what it looks like. So now let's talk about equity. And when I get into equity, I want to start off by saying what it is not. And I think this is very important because equity sounds like equality. And obviously there are similarities there, but it is a very specific difference that exists. So with equality, we are talking about people being equal, obviously, people being treated equally. So for example, in kindergarten, oftentimes when we have children, we want to make sure if we give one kid a banana, the other one gets a banana. That is equality. Moving up, fast forwarding to a more adult scenario, if we have two project managers, we want to ensure that they are paid equally for doing the same work. That is dealing with equality, a very important component, a very important concept and component of equity. Equity is taking it another step. What equity is saying specifically is that in order for us to ensure equality within our environment, we have to make equitable efforts. So what does that mean? That means if we have an organization, and I'm just using this randomly, not that it's a common scenario at all, but if we have an organization that, say for example, on the leadership board, it's 97% European American or white or whatever word you want to use, and it's 3% other, well, what we would want to say with that regard is, how do we make a more equitable environment on that leadership board? Well, one might say, well, let's just simply be fair in our promotions, in our succession planning, and treat everyone equally, and then they will rise in a distributed way to the top. Well, those who are proponents of an equitable environment would say, they will never be able to be equal if you are not making equitable efforts. And so that basically means supporting these underrepresented groups, these diverse groups, some call minority groups, in a very specific way, giving even extra attention and effort in order to help them become equal. So it's not equal treatment. It is equitable treatment. It's basically extra attention, extra effort for those targeted underrepresented groups in order to create, ultimately, hopefully, an equal scenario, an equal situation. Because those organizations and individuals of that thought realize that it is going to be very hard to systemically change a cycle of where 97% of the leadership or of the organizational body is of one category. And in order to expedite that or to even make it realistic, they put into place efforts that increase equity, that make it more equitable. What can those efforts look like? How can they manifest? Well, they can look like sponsorship programs where there are specific executive sponsors who are assigned to specific underrepresented groups. Mentors, which are very similar to sponsors. It can look like leadership programs that are specifically targeting underrepresented groups. It can look like slates that are ensuring an ample abundant level of diversity in order to ensure that representation on specific levels. But what it definitely is it's very intentional, and it is an effort, the opposite of equal, in order to get the outcome of equal or something that makes more sense, that is more evenly distributed with regard to whatever your population and or goals are. I hope this helps. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out because I love to discuss this. And please do share it with anyone who you believe would benefit from this information. And of course, have a wonderful day.